I think the most important thing the American people should know is that according to all of our experts, the risk of contracting the coronavirus for the average American remains low. Nevertheless, beginning in January, this president took unprecedented action, suspending all travel from China, quarantining Americans that came home. We recently established screening in Italy and in South Korea, while we put travel advisories on areas of those countries. But our focus is specifically now on putting the health and safety of Americans first. And we have over 100 Americans who've contracted the disease. Most are recovering and doing well. I'll be traveling to Washington State to meet with Governor Inslee and ensure that that the state of Washington has all the support that they need to confront that concentration of cases. But the American people can be confident that we're ready. Thanks to the leadership of this president, the dedication of our healthcare professionals at every level, and to no less extent, Lou, the dedication of governors around the country, state health officials, we're leaning into this effort. It's an all hands on deck approach, and it's going to stay that way until we find our way through the coronavirus.
The coordination with state and local governments, you as a former governor, the president chose you in part because of your vast experience and your knowledge of the country. The relationship with the first responders, the healthcare facilities, right, and the state governors and state governments as well, is that going as you want it?
It is. It was one of the first things I did a week ago today when the president tapped me to lead the White House response to the coronavirus, Lou. I reached out to governors in the states that have been impacted, had coronavirus cases. This Monday, we spoke to 50 state governors and governors of three territories to assure them that we understand, this president understands, that while the full resources of the federal government are being brought to this effort, we know that it's state health officials and local health officials and those incredible health care workers that are on the front lines. And that's the reason why we've been working tirelessly to make more masks available, more gloves available. I'll be traveling through Minnesota tomorrow, right, stopping at 3M, where as Congress is completing their work over the next week on a funding bill, we're going to make sure that that we contract for and make available the kind of masks and gloves and eye protection so that our healthcare workers can be there for whatever impacts this coronavirus has in communities in this country.
The vaccine, the discussion about vaccines, antivirals, the president has made it clear that he wants American business to be moving rapidly to produce both for the American people. At the same time, we know we're extraordinarily dependent upon China for antibiotics, for ingredients in pharmaceuticals. Your thoughts about that dependency and what kind of an obstacle is it for us?
Well, you know, the president established in January a whole of government approach, but what he tasked me to do was to make sure that it was a whole of America approach.
Right.
And earlier this week, he had all the leaders of the pharmaceutical companies come in to the cabinet room. We talked about the availability of medicines for Americans broadly. But we got some very encouraging news. Our pharmaceutical companies have now formed a consortium to share information in the development, not just of vaccines, which we think a vaccine will be in clinical trials in 6 weeks, will be available to the public in a year or a year and a half. But we think long before that, therapeutics, the medicines that people can take if they contract the coronavirus to get relief,
right,
we think that could literally be available in a matter of months. Our pharmaceutical industry is stepping forward. We've had meetings today with the airline industry, with nursing home leaders around the country, and I just came from a very important meeting with the top CEOs of commercial laboratories in this country, because while testing is available now,
right,
state health departments can administer a coronavirus test. Universities can do a test there. We have 1.5 million tests going out in 2,500 test kits this week. To get a coronavirus test to your local doctor, to your local CVS or MedCheck, We need our commercial laboratories to work. And literally, just moments ago, I was informed that our commercial laboratories have also formed a consortium. They'll be working closely together to roll testing out by the thousands of additional tests within the next week. And literally, we want this test to be available for people all across the country. By partnering with our commercial laboratories, right. We know we can make that happen in the weeks ahead.
Do you have a deadline or a projection as to when they will be available?
Well, as I mentioned, and I talked to a few governors this morning, Lou.
Right.
Thanks to the FDA's efforts this weekend at the president's direction, now state laboratories can conduct coronavirus tests on their own under an approved procedure. University laboratories around the country can do the same. States across the country can now conduct this test, but we also have kits going out, 2,500 kits, 1.5 million tests to hospitals around the country that particularly in the areas that are affected or have requested it. But again, what Dr. Birx shared with me is what's most important to millions of Americans who may be concerned about this, if there's a sure. case of coronavirus in their community, is literally to be able to go to your local doctor, to go to your, you know, minute clinic, and know
That's
that
great.
That'll be available. We think that literally we'll have thousands of those tests begin to be processed through our commercial laboratories next week. And believe it or not, I was just told, given the immense capacity of our commercial laboratories, they told me within a matter of weeks that could be in the millions.
And I've looked at your schedule, and I know you're going to be, you've always been the busiest fellow to hold this office. You're going to be even busier now, and we wish you Godspeed and appreciate your time.
Thank you, Lou, so very much. The American people, again, should just know the risk of the average American to contract the coronavirus remains low, but this president has deployed the full resources of the federal government to confront the corona crisis. We're bringing industry together, and we will find our way through this with the very best that puts the health of America first.
Mr. Vice President, thank you.
Thank you, Lou.
Appreciate it.